Tracy.
Awesome. That's really great to see. So, we got some new faces in the room. So today, first off, can you hear me? Yes, no. But today, the point of today's workshop, I'm going to call it, is first to give a brief on what's going on with the project, the status of it, construction, all the kind of traffic stuff we're seeing. But the purpose of today's workshop is really to think about how do we take public space? How do we take, after words are born, make something new intersections, how do we take that and make it something that really represents the community and the attractive public space? And what we are going to do is one of these three people in here, we'll be giving you all a workshop, sort of brainstorm and think about what you all feel. So we're very excited. Does anyone need translation like
this?
So does anyone have any questions about the format before we get started? Awesome, so I'd like to introduce Dong Tran from the Bureau of Engineering. He'll be briefing you on the project, or the status, what's going on. The main focus of our workshop for our event today will be the design components. So if there's specific construction schedule questions that require long dialogue, feel free to talk to your engineer and come to your office and have a more in-depth discussion. So with that, so.
Thank you. Good evening. My name is Dong Tran. I'm the project manager for this project. I'm from the I have here Jerry Hernandez. He's the construction manager for this project as well.
Monitoring
some baseline of the noise or vibration to improve the apartment at the project. That was ongoing. You can see that as we go to demolition and perhaps the project is going. We've been working closely with Department of Transportation as well as your street lighting on revising or updating the traffic control plan from stage one. Keep in mind when we say stage one, it consists of six phases, and then recently we have to phase one, phase two, phase three, phase four, five, and six, and so on. So we've been working closely with Department of Transportation as well as street lighting. We have their approval to implement up to the stage one, which consists of six phases. We have a temporary traffic signal, temporary traffic light has been approved. You've probably seen some street lighting or traffic signal out there today. We're waiting for DWP to provide service so we can start to implement the temporary traffic signal light. When that happens, we're going to continue to remove the median island on the bridge and shift it southbound of Huntington Drive north onto Soto. We're going to shift it one side of the bridge. We're going to demolish half the bridge. And that's going to happen probably in August of this year. We're going to demolish half the bridge, particularly the area of Mission Road and Soto Street. Area. That's going to be our first demolition report that will occur in August. We have been working closely with Bureau of Street Services. We have come to an agreement that Bureau of Street Services will maintain the landscaping area. They also require us to revise the landscaping to satisfy their requirement. That is part of the reason that we are here today, and that's part of the reason that we retain Northeast Street. We'd like to take that opportunity since the landscaping plans of the landscape area will be changed, will be revised. We want to be here, and the Northeast Street will be presented to you, and you have the opportunity to comment on it before we finalize it, before we actually build it. So this will be one of at least two or three meetings with you, with the community. So your input today and the next couple of meetings are very important.
Question, what is the budget for the landscaping?
I don't have the exact number, but we do have a bit. For the landscaping area. I can look it up to see how much for that area.
So it's more than
10,000? Oh, it's more than 10,000. We have the plans ready. The plans were previously approved, but because now Bureau of Street Services is going to maintain it, so they have a set of requirements, what needs to be done, what needs to be changed in order for them to maintain it.
Are we able to look those requirements up online?
I can follow up on that. Their comments are very extensive as well. We can provide a copy of that.
Well, I think we'd like to know.
Northeast Street, what we want to do is we want to bring Northeast Street, for example, the landscape, and as well as the art component. They're going to present it to you, and they're going to hear from you. Want to hear your input. So when they revise the plans have to satisfy the services requirements as well as they're going to meet some community, what the community wants. I think mainly it will be the landscape at first. I think I'm trying to get them to art component as well, because I think the art component and the landscape have to go together. Otherwise, it wouldn't look nice. So that is part of the scope work that
briefing on why we're doing this. Before there had been some presentations about art and sort of how this would look, and there have been some definite concerns in the community about, is that what the community wants? Has there been proper outreach? Has there been proper incorporation of community input? And one thing is the Bureau of Engineering and our office felt that it was really important that a project of this magnitude really needs to have the support from the community in terms of what happens there, right? So Bureau of Engineering works to retain Northeast Trees as a consultant to work on the landscaping as well as the art elements of it within the city's guidelines. And to answer your questions, those guidelines are like, you have to be, you know, X amount of feet from a sprinkler head or something like that. They're very technical sort of conditions. However, this provides an opportunity to sort of transform how the city does the process. Usually, you know, they present an art piece and they try and sell it to the community. A lot of times it doesn't work. And we said, okay, how do we rethink that? And how do we sort of start with the community and then work towards something that's practical? So it's both nature but also well as the structural elements that can be involved. If people feel that there's some sort of, you know, there's a landscaping way that, you know, we want to incorporate some, you know, element of the old bridge or whatever it is into it, that's something that these discussions are going to bring up. That's something that will allow the city throughout the construction process and the design process to refine that existing design. Because we felt as a city that design needed to be refined to reflect what the community needs. Does that answer your question?
Savage portion of the concrete, anything like that,
you might require additional testing that requires some much more work than you think. So it's not as simple as you say, you save a piece of concrete and it's good. Okay. So I mean, we want to hear from the community. We want to get as soon as possible.
What are the monetary amounts of your startup funds
for
this project?
The contract is roughly, I believe, $9.1 million. The total project is about, I believe, about $13 million.
So how is it make up the difference?
No, the construction contract is 9.1. The budget for the project is about
$13 million. And is
the city paying for that? Or I'm sorry? Does the city pay for that? We secure most of the funding from Federal Highway Bridge Program. That's from Federal.
That's federal.
That's federal money. City come up with local match, mainly from Prop C or Prop G. We also receive funding from Metro.
Do we know that that money is secure?
It is secure. If it's not as secure, we wouldn't be able to go into construction.
Yeah, you know, I need to see a progress
around,
right?
No.
Especially something
as magnitude. It is. It is a goal that the money is in. Because actually this includes the north-south movement of the drive and soil. We also will have bike lanes for metro to give us some money for bike lanes as well. XL paving. No, we cannot remove the bridge. It doesn't realign the street. Actually, the title of the project is Soto Street Bridge Removal Project.
But what we get is improvement.
Yeah.
It's not the opposite of the water. So I'm calling it removal because it's
misleading. It's Soto Street, Huntington Drive, Mission Road, intersection. I think that would be a better traffic flow improvement. That's better. So with that, I would like to introduce Northeast Trees. They do a lot of great things in the community. We're trying to figure out who's someone that understands the community, knows the dynamics of every, you know, all the components of sort of the east side of Los Angeles. They have a really good track record in the community. They've done stuff at Ascot Hills. I know Aaron's done stuff at Hazard, all sorts of places. So with that, I would like to introduce Northeast Trees.
Well, thank you. My name is Aaron Thomas. I'm the urban forestry manager with Northeast Trees. I've been with the organization for 20 years now. This is my worker, Holly Harper. She's an architect, licensed architect with